What's up, y'all? Welcome back to Kairos Place. First off, if you're hearing this, I sincerely hope you're doing well. As for me and my family, we're facing COVID head on, it seems. It's kind of a miracle that this is the first time, honestly. My wife's a nurse and I work in public health, so we've been working around it since the beginning. But it is what it is. I've got a lot of friends that are either in quarantine or have recently quarantined, and it's a good time to chill out for a bit, be thankful for what's not going wrong. We were actually supposed to head out to the beach on vacation today, and my nurse wife and my respiratory therapist, younger sister, were very much looking forward to getting out of COVID units and spending some time in the sunshine, but all that got blown up. So for right now, let's just make the next few minutes about nothing but Dark Souls. No reason to think about anything else. So whether you're chilling, trying to get ready for bed, or catching me early in the morning, hope you have a few moments to just hang out, reflect a little bit maybe. I hope you enjoy some of the music. If you're anything like me, just the sounds of Dark Souls is calming. It's my video game comfort food. So let's get into it. I'll catch up with you guys after the Sanctuary Guardian fight. We'll talk about Artorias a little bit.
The not rich, the miscall, the mystery, the rest to save. I'll penetrate when there ain't no way. own land. Into the great escape, 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 into the great escape.
Okay. So I need to think through my game plan here. I really think my dagger is going to not do a lot for me. So I've got to use my buffs very wisely. I also know from previous experience with smaller weapons that it's very hard to knock him out of his power-up phase. So I don't even know if that's worth trying to do. So this first fight might be a little experimental, maybe testing some things. I think my best bet is going to be to just stack on damage early on, because I don't want to be using power within once he's buffed, because he could one-shot me if I don't have full health. And I'll never have full health if power within is on, so I think I'm going all out, straight out of the gate. trying to be really aggressive, get as much damage as I can in early, and then just slow down and try to be cautious and not get hit later after he's double or triple buffed. And I think that's gonna have to be my game plan. So let's see how it goes. I can get down with that. So we begin again. I got hit twice by the circle spin slash, or the two spins, and that's gonna be one of the few, I think, that once he's buffed will completely take me out. So I gotta make sure that I'm not around for that one. Game plan was the right one, though. Stack damage early, because I can already tell. I think my power within was still going, but when it runs out, that damage is going to be very low. If I had the capacity, I would count how many hits it's going to take me to kill him, because I think it's a lot. Let's do this. worse that time. It was because I didn't turn my music back on, though. That's what it was. I'm gonna go ahead and kindle this bonfire up a few times. Just so I don't forget once I dip below 10. Difficult Dark Souls bosses, especially doing them in a way you're not used to. I've never fought him with a weapon this short, I don't think, and definitely this weak. I think even my Soul level 1 run, I'm pretty confident I was doing more damage than I'm going to be doing when Power Within runs out, for sure. I think I was doing similar damage, unbuffed with the, I was using the reinforced club. I think I was buffing it with lightning resins. But yeah, Dark Souls, difficult Dark Souls bosses are kind of like meditations within themselves. The focus that it takes. Start glancing down at that health bar, seeing how much damage you've done, and that's the first misstep. Taking that focus away. Trying to make a decision what kind of music I want. This is it right here. I'm gonna take an extra pause, but this is the one. This is the one where I make it come together.
Thank you. from your little black book. You can call me all your favorites. Oh, I love those dirty looks. You know I'll be drunk and waiting on the steps of St. Anthony's.
Knuckle blood stains the door frame. Frustration both ways. You see me knock, I see you gaze through the peak and watch me sneak far away. My pleas to the shades, I'm out of sight, Florida lines. It's nonsense from a dime. I spent your mind, time stop for us. Cost of a heart, a cost it, don't blink. Nothing so strangled like us, nothing deranged like that love. Nothing explains away the way I played, like new things to break. Live under your ribs, a toy box, and out the plug in. Tune out, give out what's yours, like put in doubt. Play the mouse in the mouth, like don't let me die. Like don't let me die. I could never lay you down to sleep. Take a knee, spilling salt and shame upon your pretty feet. With a head full of bourbon, I do this though I love you and I think you hurt me on purpose.
That was a lot of fun. I enjoyed that thoroughly. It doesn't get any more come down to the wire than that. I felt real badass, and then I walked the wrong way out of the building, so I decided to play it off and go punch Chester. But I've got my big goofy ear to ear grin going on after I have a good boss fight that gets my heart rate up a little bit, so. Tonight is a win. I've kind of lost sense of time. I have no idea how long it's taken me to beat those. I feel like I just fought him for like 35 minutes. I'm sure it was just a couple minutes, but it felt like an eternity. So I'm going to go ahead and end this one here just in case it's running long. And we'll pick back up next time. I may go ahead and go lure Calamite out so you guys don't have to watch me do that run. But I'll probably do... I don't know if I want to do Calamite or Manus first, but... We'll see. We'll see next time. Thanks for hanging out. And I'll catch you later.